Okay, I cheated and added a HTML code. I still wanted my yellow background. Is this thing still recording? Okay. So, yeah, I went back to loose ends and I just put in the code for background color there. Whatever. Okay, yeah, I finished it up. That part was just annoying me. I didn't see any reason to leave it like that if I didn't want to. And I didn't want to. So, yeah, I still wanted my yellow background. Okay, so I went ahead and threw that code, background color code in there. All right. Yeah. Needless to say, I ran out of time. I did get halfway through installing the, putting in internal links, the pagination issue thingy I was having. Yeah, I did the sitemap page. I'm also connecting all the things with next page links on the bottom of every page. So, yeah, I got halfway through that and ran out of time, of course. Yeah. Yeah, that background color was still bothering me, apparently. So, okay. So I threw in another couple of minutes and pulled up the code online and stuck it in there. Okay. What else? I'm trying to determine all the possible expenses. I'm gonna go on, no, I'm gonna start because they'll probably have me searching through it. It was enough to get the code in there for the moment. What else? How much they charge to use their platform. The freelancers, the Fiverr and Upworks. So, I gotta look up that. And then whichever one doesn't blow me away, if there's anything I can... Remember, I only have to use it for 2 or 3 months just to get stuff started. And I'll figure out what to do after that. So, whichever one doesn't get me spitting blood, I need to start studying the site. First, I have to figure out how I'm going to classify myself and seeing what other people are doing and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, in the back of my mind, I still had that $49.99 thing, but I gotta loosen up my concepts as far as that's concerned. I don't even know what I'm dealing with anymore at this point. Yeah, I was thinking, basic business model question. All right. Oh, and also how they have everything set up. If I have Yoast, does my client need to have Yoast? All I should need is their password. Like all that Facebook nonsense. I did need an account if the person I hired had one. In any case, I'd be a fishmonger teaching everyone how to fish. Very philanthropic of me, but what the heck? And repeat business? What repeat business? Okay. So this is the kind of thing I'm starting to think about. But I also recall that the URL actually changes when you install the Yoast. So no, it's actually attached to the website. I don't think you can do it like that. Now the other one didn't do that, but it did require you to create an account. So I'm thinking, you know what? I might actually end up going with all-in-one. Just to do the account thing and not having to be physically, because why am I telling people the entire layout? I'm really shooting myself in the foot. Very nice of me and everything, but I mean, is that the way to run a business? Not a successful one, I wouldn't imagine. I don't know. Because initially, yeah, they still might need you. There are tons of steps to get through, obviously. But after you have it set up, it's all set up, right? So, I don't know. So, you know, you're just giving all your business to the $75 an hour people. And you're setting everything up very nice at a next to nothing price. So it's like, and the fact that it's only going to be a one-time thing, you're being very nice about it. Because, I mean, these people are making very good living just doing these services, and you're just handing it over kind of thing. So it's like, so I need to slow down a bit. Find out what this Fiverr and Upwork thing charges. And whichever one doesn't blow me away, I need to start reading up and studying up and figuring out what exactly I'm doing. And find out what I actually have access to and how I can use it to do all this. If I can use it to do all this. I mean, yes, obviously, personal use, yes. Business use, it's not looking like it, right? Not without just handing everything over. So, I don't know. It's nice to be nice, but everyone has to make a living, right? That's where we've gotten to that point. Now it's a business. Now it's a business. So, yeah. So trying to turn into Little Miss Moneybags here, because you got enough people cutting people's throats without you shooting yourself in the foot kind of thing, right? Okay, so what did I do? I did my sitemap page, and tying up loose ends. Went halfway through, I'm putting in the internal links. The external links, I'm going to connect it to my domain. The images, well, there's going to be a lot of videos. I don't know about images. I'm a video kind of person. But I was thinking about that intro thing. I mean, I know what it's about. But what if I went onto someone else's website? Would I really bother reading through the whole thing to find out what it's... I probably wouldn't. I was starting to rethink that intro paragraph. And the same thing with the videos. Fine, I know what the videos are like, but I think the images are probably a better idea. You're not committing time and effort to something that may not interest you at all. So maybe I do need to put that intro paragraph in there. And images were always good anyway. So The copyright thing, though. Another three websites, Pixabay and two others that have free material that you can use. The other two I couldn't get access to them when I was in Moscow, so that's why I didn't really bother much with that. I think Pixabay, though. Yeah, I don't know which ones did. Or was it the other way around? I'm trying to remember which how that was. It's in a splash. Maybe it was Pixabay that didn't do it. I don't know. One of those two. Out of the three, one of them did. I can't remember which one it was, though. Could have been Splash. I don't know. Anyway. So. Yeah, I still got the VPN or whatever they call that stuff. So, whatever. Alright, boys and girls. Yeah, basic business model. I did finish it up. Alright, I cheated a bit and added the color code because that was kind of bothering me. That's pretty basic, I think. If you don't want a blank white page, right? So, anyway, I don't know. I stuck it in there. It was bothering me. And that's it. Now I've got a... today is... No, I never did get to the application, so I'm going to do that today. But... first, obviously, sign up for the premium. And, yeah. And just continue editing not only this website, but my domain. And I may start another website for Time to Go International and edit that. I'm going to edit everything I can manage to edit in the next 20 days using this Yoast Premium thing, alright? So, yeah, whatever. But I also have to be looking for an SEO tool that doesn't require WordPress. Because all I know now is something I can use when I have WordPress business plan for personal use. And that's all I know. As far as I can, if I can use it on someone else's website, as long as I have the password, all these things, so I'm obviously going to have to be familiar with one or two additional SEO tools beyond WordPress. So that's where I'm at now. Okay. That's all my mind's dealing with at the moment. It's just kind of spilling over. So, yeah. All right, that's it. It is. This thing has gone blank on me and doesn't want to go up. Come back up. Well, that's not good. Oh, there it goes. It is 8.02 a.m. Yeah, it's a little later because, like I said, I wanted to look up that HTML code and stick it in there. It is 8.03 a.m. Saturday, isn't it? Yes, Saturday morning, November 19th. 2022 here in Grand Ole Jackson, Mississippi. As always, stay safe, stay healthy, and I will talk to you later. Take care.